New tonight, CAL FIRE is investigating a house fire in Hollister. The home on Ashburg Estates Drive was completely destroyed around 5 o'clock this morning. Some say it may have been no accident. Action News reporter Tom Miller is live on the scene with the story for us.
Well, Aaron, this 8,000-square-foot mansion sitting behind me in the Hollister Hills is now gone. It changed owners just 2 weeks ago, with Wells Fargo owning it now, and some estranged family members say they believe foul play may have been at stake here. Firefighters were here at the crack of dawn battling a blaze that eventually destroyed this Hollister mansion worth millions.
The first arriving engine company found the house approximately 40 to 50% involved with fire already. And unfortunately, at that point, that means all you can do is really just stop it from spreading too much further. And, you know, that's why, again, unfortunately, the house is a total loss.
Family members say something is off, though. 2 weeks ago, the house was foreclosed on by Wells Fargo. In an interview with Action News in November, inside this very home, 89-year-old Otilla Carl says she didn't want the loan.
I wasn't involved with the negotiation of the loan. I didn't know beforehand that I was going to have to sign off on a document that was put in front of me at the closing.
Otilla's attorney says at the time, the odds were against her.
The disparity of power, economic and otherwise, between a large institution and a consumer is so great that it's always loaded against the consumer.
Her lawyer was right, and Carl lost the case. Family members who didn't want to be identified said Mrs. Carl changed when she started dating a man about half her age who had been in and out of prison. They say that when she and her boyfriend realized they couldn't have the house and that Wells Fargo was getting it, they may have had a little bit of foul play leading to some arson and this fire behind me. Miss Carl still had some possessions in the house, including lots of furniture and this Lexus. Now it's up to fire investigators to figure out what started the fire and if any legal action needs to be taken. Carl says she was in San Francisco last night on a getaway to take her mind off this foreclosure. Investigators have been here throughout the week or throughout the day, but they say it could take weeks before they know what started the fire.
All right, Tom, thank you. CAL FIRE says even though the house was completely destroyed, it could have been worse. A clearance of 100 feet around the property kept the fire from spreading to other homes.